Ted Drewe's is located at 6726 Chippewa Street. By definition, frozen custard must have at least 10% butterfat and 1.4% egg yolk. The amount of air, also known as overrun, truly separates frozen custard from traditional ice cream. Traditional ice cream has as much as 100% overrun, which causes ice crystals to form. Frozen custard has 20% overrun or less. This reduction of air is what gives frozen custards its silky smooth texture.
Ted Drewe's Chippewa location is open February through December, so it's only closed in January.
Regular chocolate concrete with banana and cookie dough. Thank you.
Is that all the input?
Yeah.
Sure do.
This
flip
is,
it outside
this
down.
Is BS.
We'll do it over there.
Kelsey?
She got a milkshake.
Ladies, how is it?
Delicious. I can't do that for so good. Ultimate test.
Sophie, what was in that?
A concrete.
What kind?
That's how it's supposed to
be. Yeah, banana and cookie dough.
Ted Drewe's has been selling frozen custard and Christmas trees for decades. It all started when Ted Sr. opened his first ice cream store in Florida in 1929, followed the next year by another store on Natural Bridge in St. Louis and the South Grand store in 1931. In 1941, the family opened the second Southside stand, which is the current Chippewa location, Old Route 66. In 1958, the Southside stands were all that remained.
According to Ted Jr., the success of the operation has brought it nationwide attention in the form of offers to franchise the stands. He said such offers pour in quite frequently. However, he has never agreed to franchise and says that he never will. To Ted's credit, much of his success to his father. Ted Sr. was a St. Louis attraction, winning the Tennis Muni Championship each year from 1926 to 1935. He has also won the National Public Parks title 4 straight years in the middle 1920s.
Each fall, Ted travels to Nova Scotia, where he personally selects the best Canadian balsam fir Christmas trees to bring home to St. Louis and sell in the parking lot of Ted Drewe's.
Although Ted refuses to franchise, Ted Drewe's custard is available in select St. Louis grocery stores.
Ted Drewe's reason for refusal to franchise is that it is a family-run establishment that prioritizes the values of quality and care. They fear that a franchise would jeopardize their personal control over their exceptional product.
Some Ted Drewe's favorites include Banana Split, the Dutchman, the Christie, the Hawaiian, the Cardinal Sin, and the Caramel Apple Sundae. But my personal favorite is an M&M Concrete.
And that's it.
St. Louis tradition 75 years.
Jen?
Oh yeah, that's true.
Jen, how do you get to Ted Drewe's?
Well, Kelsey, I'm so glad you asked. You turn left onto Clayton Road and then turn right onto 141 going north. Take Highway 40 going east and exit on McCausland Avenue. Then turn left on Arsenal and then a right on Jameson. Turn left on Chippewa, and then Ted Drewe's will be on your right.
Ted Drewe Sr. was a professional tennis player back
yes.
then. So he taught the seminary students in Florida every winter. And so they would go there every winter and they started a store in 1930. But that store was started in a traveling carnival, not a standalone store. It started in a traveling carnival first, and then they built a store in Florida. And then, obviously, when they came back after the winter, they opened a store up on Natural Bridge in 1930.
Great. Okay. Thank you. And then, yeah. So you guys obviously receive a lot of offers to franchise.
We do.
And it's never going to happen?
I don't think so. Not while I'm around or Ted, because the idea we have about it is flattering to have people ask us. It means that they don't like us, but we feel like if we franchise, we wouldn't be able to keep control of what we're doing. If, let's say we already have two stores, and right now our family is working enough in these two stores and we have enough control. But if we open a third or fourth or fifth, we feel like we may not be able to have that control, and it would stretch us too thin, and then maybe our quality would drop, our service may drop, and we don't want that.
That's very important to you guys.
Yes, it is.
So what would you say is your most popular flavor or concrete?
Well, if you're going by strict numbers, the most popular concrete is the chocolate concrete.
The chocolate concrete.
Yes, that's the one that is ordered the most.
Okay.
But I would say that right behind that is the chocolate chip or the heat bar.
Okay.
Great.
And how many different flavors do you guys have?
Well, we have about 24 different flavors. But obviously, if you're a math major, you make combinations, it can be endless.
Correct. Okay.
But yeah, about 22.
And how did these classic baseball cups start? Because I know I love getting my ice cream in the cap.
Well, golly, it's been a long time. I think probably 15, 20 years ago, we saw these caps somewhere, and we thought, boy, the kids would really like these. And so it wasn't just the kids that got them. Because we started ordering, we could get every team. We found that out after making some phone calls. I think back when we started it, we didn't use the internet back then either, so it was way back there.
Right.
So we made some phone calls. We got started. We really can't stop it because
yeah.
they're so popular.
They are. I know. I can't wait. And then what's your favorite flavor?
Boy, my favorite now is a strawberry with cone coat and pecans. It's sort of like a chocolate-covered strawberry
mm-hmm.
With nuts.
Okay.
And that's my favorite now. See, it does change because I used to really love, and I still do, the peaches with macadamias. And another favorite of mine is Heath Bar and the mocha flavor, the coffee
okay.
flavor.
Do you eat the ice cream a lot? Or the
do I
concrete? Yeah.
Oh, I do. Is
that every day?
I have to, yeah. This is
well, you look great. You wouldn't be able to tell.
Somebody will taste. Somebody has to try it. You know, because you're testing every day.
Yeah.
And my goodness, it's fun.
Yeah.
I'm envious.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about the Christmas trees?
I sure can.
Awesome.
The Christmas trees are on the same lot, I guess you know. And we do that every winter. And the reason why we started that is that was back in the 50s. And this store, the custard stand wasn't open all year like it is now or most of the year. We're open 11 months out of the year now.
Oh, wow.
And that's the store here.
Mm-hmm.
But back then, in the 50s, the store opened in late March or early April, and then it closed in October. So it was only open 6 or 7 months. And
mm-hmm.
so what does the family do when you're in a family business? What do you do for money or income after that? Well, the Christmas tree idea came from Ted Drewe Sr., and they started buying Christmas trees, and they knew somebody in Canada.
Okay, so Nova Scotia, they
That's where Nova Scotia started. Yes, they did.
Okay.
And so they bought some, for the first few years, they bought trees from farmers up there, and then finally, Ted Sr. decided to buy some land and told his son, Ted Drewe Jr., who's alive now, to buy land. So now Ted has land up there, and that's what we do. Still do.
Great.
And the trees sell very well.
Yeah.
Well, we just started. Go ahead.
I've heard people come here, they buy your Christmas trees every year, and some don't even, or back in the day, didn't even know you sold ice cream.
That's right. That's correct.
Yeah.
And we didn't even know that we could sell frozen custard with the Christmas trees.
For
years, and we didn't even have frozen custard open.
Uh-huh.
But I think in probably 85, when we added on the store, that's when we added more on. This is the old part of the building. This one was in 1941. But that section there, we did in 85. But we didn't even have heat in this little store, except for a little heater I put back there.
A space heater?
That's what it was. And so when we added that, we added central heat. Right? And we thought, well, if we got heat in here, why can't we sell frozen custard? And then we opened the windows, and people started buying trees, too. And
it's great. It really is. It's the best.